Tonight, it is a big talker in the Triad. A local church is in deep debt. It is in danger of losing its building. We are talking about Greater Church in Northeast Winston-Salem after reports that it defaulted on its mortgage last year. Tonight, in a WXI 12 News exclusive, we are hearing from the leader of that church, Bishop Sheldon McCarter. But first, here's what we do know. Greater Church owes about $3.3 million to a bank in Tennessee unless a bankruptcy judge steps in. If it is not paid by next Friday, the church could face foreclosure next Friday. The church was founded in 1893 and Bishop McCarter took over in 1988. Forsyth County Sheriff Bobby Kimbrough posted on Facebook calling the black church, quote, the most powerful entity in the community. He is asking people to show up at Greater Cleveland Church on Sunday and make a donation to help save the building. Tonight, we are hearing from Bishop McCarter to set the record straight about exactly what's happening. Bishop, thank you so much for joining us tonight. What is your response to the information that came out about the foreclosure of one of the most prominent churches in the Triad?
Well, my response is definitely authentic. It is presently a very unfortunate, unpleasant reality, but the good news is it's not final. You know, we've been in this situation dealing with Apex Bank, who has literally has not been that friendly or amicable to us. And but nevertheless, again, we have been believing God, certainly carrying out the things that we need to do. It's definitely been a challenge for us. But one thing I do know, that God is going to make a for us. We are people of faith. We are people who believe in the power of prayer. And that's what we're going to stand on. And of course, even going forward, yes, it's a challenge. But one thing we do know, we're coming out fine.
So, Bishop, you acknowledge that there is a debt. How did the church get to this point?
Well, basically, when you think about just the changing of the times that we're in, of course, the whole idea of being a mega church for this particular region is certainly something that people always look at. But just during transitions and over the span of time, our membership has decreased. And in the process of membership decreasing, you know, revenue decreases. But nevertheless, our church is still very, very strong. And again, we're definitely bouncing our way back as we always do. And of course, that's kind of put us in the situation that we're in. But we're right there at that peak. And we know we're going to get over the hump. God is going to certainly make the way. So even going forth, we believe, again, what the word of God declares. And we stand on the promises of God. And because of that reason, we know we're going to make it through.
And very quickly, Bishop McCarter, a lot of people are sounding off about this. You have some support. We heard from Sheriff Kimbrough as well, but there's also people on the other side. What do you say to the community?
Well, certainly the support from the community has been absolutely amazing. You know, there is something shouting out other things, but I pay no attention to that. I don't have time for chatter. You know, we are thanking God for the community support from the mayor, Sheriff Kimbrough, the councilman, councilman in the city. Everybody is calling us, showing us the put. Judges are calling us because of the very reason that they know what Greater Church means to this community, the impact, the innovative ideas of ministry we've brought to this city, the souls that we have saved, the lives that we have changed, the people that have been touched, the people that we have helped over and over and over again. And so I thank God for their support. But most of all, I thank God for my Greater Church family. They are standing strong with us. They are wrapping their arms around me and the co-pastor and our family and said, Bishop, we're standing with you because we know we're going to get through this. And that's exactly what's going to happen. And we are certainly praying, fasting, believing God, and we know he's going to make the way.
All right. Thank you so much, Bishop McCarter. We do appreciate your time. It's also worth noting that a court hearing is set for next Wednesday, May 22nd. In the meantime, the church is opening to the community. They want them to come through and support on Sunday. However, the service is closed to the media.